Hey, how's it going, guys? My name is Alan with Dream Big Live Tiny Co. Today, I'm shooting this super cool, tiny, shiny, tiny house here in East Austin. Now, if you're familiar with the Austin market, it has been exploding in regards to tiny homes with the recent approval of accessory dwelling units within the city limits, which has really opened up the game for people to start building tiny homes in their backyards and to speed up the process of actually going tiny. The tiny, shiny, tiny house, that's a tongue twister. The tiny, shiny, tiny house is an accessory dwelling unit, or more commonly known as an ADU, here in East Austin, one of Austin's hottest neighborhoods currently right now, undergoing rapid development over the last couple of years with new houses, new apartments, new places to eat, new everything. And it's super, super close to downtown. It's about 3 miles into town, or about a 10-minute drive on a good day. So without further ado, let's show you around. So this tiny house is currently set up as a short-term rental, and the location is phenomenal for those of you coming to town who want to be centrally located to the downtown sights, the nightlife, and the bustling East Austin food scene. So the tiny, shiny, tiny house is very tiny, hence the name. So for those of you who are keen to know the numbers, I literally brought a tape measure with me so I can get you the juicy details with precision. So the tiny house measures 8.5 feet wide by almost 16 feet long on the ground level, with a bedroom loft above, which gives you about 132 square feet on the ground level. But if you count the loft, because you can almost stand up with a clearance of about 60 inches, in total, the tiny house comes out to 186 square feet, probably still smaller than the room you're currently sitting in. Now, on the ground floor, you have your functional living space with a linear kitchen upon entering the home. While the kitchen wasn't built for full-time use, it still would suffice for the average person. You have a 4-burner range and oven, a custom stainless steel countertop with a small sink built into it, an apartment-sized fridge, perfect size for 1 or 2 people, a microwave, a decent amount of cabinet storage, and of course the essentials like a coffee machine and plenty of coffee to go with it. Definitely enough space to prepare some delicious eggs in the morning. Beside the kitchen is a custom-built small table for two that also works as a cozy workspace. Across the dining table is a full height closet with plenty of hanging space and storage for clothes, shoes, and pretty much anything else you want to keep hidden. Past the closet is the full size bathroom, equipped with a small vanity and sink, a flush toilet, a shower tub combo, and some handy built-in storage cubbies for towels and other essentials. So now that we have a place to cook, a place to eat and hang out, and a place to relieve ourselves of everything you will inevitably eat here in Austin, don't even get me started on the barbecue, a place to store our stuff, the only thing left is a place to rest our heads at night. The loft bedroom is accessible via an industrial galvanized pipe ladder and sits above the closet and bathroom, giving you about 54 square feet up there. The loft dimensions only allow up to a full-size bed, so I hope you're single or really like the friend you brought along. Now, out of the hundreds of tiny houses that I have stepped in or stayed in, this one has to have one of the highest clearances in the loft that I've ever seen, at 59 inches, just under 5 feet. So if you're short, or if you simply realize that this is actually a really high loft clearance, then you will be super, super happy that you can sit up in the loft without having to worry about hitting your head when you sit up or get up to use the restroom at night. So you'll come back down the stairs and you'll realize that's it. So that's the tiny house, guys. This isn't MTV Cribs. So I hope you enjoyed this short tour of the tiny, shiny, tiny house and all of its quirky features. Sitting at 8.5 by 16 feet, this tiny house is very, very small in comparison to other tiny homes. For how small this tiny house is, I have to say it feels quite spacious. And I really think it has to do with the extra high ceilings in here that give a feeling of it not being too enclosed, as well as the plentiful windows bringing in tons of natural light, and the choice of light colored walls goes a long way. If you ever find yourself in Austin or are planning a trip in the near future, this place is available to be booked on Airbnb for up to 2 guests. You can find the link in the description below. And if you're into saving money like me, You can use the link in the description below to sign up for an Airbnb account and get up to $55 off your first stay. And lastly, if you enjoyed this video tour, it would mean the world to me if you guys gave this video a thumbs up and left a sincere comment about what your favorite part about this tiny house was. I'll tell you that my favorite part was the really tall loft clearance. And if you really love the tour, please be sure to subscribe to the channel for upcoming tiny house tours for you to binge watch very soon. Hope you all have a wonderful rest of your day, and here is a little cinematic sequence to send you on your way.